Get ready to match the stars. Fred Travellina, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Ladies' Man, Betty Kennedy, from Molten Mindy, Bob Donner, and Fanny Flagg, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Raymer.
Thank you, friends. Is everyone ready?
Yes.
Yes, actually.
Splendid.
Thank you.
Good. All right. You wore...
She almost wore
the dress backwards. Now, here are we have Tammy Adams and Charlene Bennett. Yay! Now, Tammy, please refresh our memories about where you're from and all that sort of thing.
I'm a single lady. I live in Santa Monica.
Yep. And you're a butcher.
Westwood is a butcher.
Yes. Charlene?
I'm from Los Angeles, and I'm a reservation sales agent for a major airline.
All right. And she won the first game, Charlene did, and she has $500 to her credit. And now we're in round two of game number two. And Tammy, since you're ahead, you'll go first.
B, please.
B it is. It's 1-0. It's a close score here. Oops. Now, yeah. Muggsy said... I went to the world's toughest school. I'll tell you, the only way you could get any attention was to blank your teacher.
I don't blank.
I know that. Tammy, Muggsy said, I went to the world's toughest school. The only way you could get any attention was to blank your teacher.
Slug your teacher?
Slug. All right. Well, that would... It's like the old joke about the guy and the mule. You know, what are you beating the mule for? Yes.
You know, this is Sylvester Stallone. Hey, over your agent.
Hey, Sylvester, did you ever slug a teacher?
No, I try to learn in good English. You know, I used to punch him.
Punch is a
that's
slug?
Right,
yeah, that's one.
All that rough stuff gets me very nervous. Attack.
Attack. All right. See, attack would not necessarily involve punching. You could butt the teacher with your head and knock her out that way. What'd you say, Betty?
Well,
the toughest school in town, the only way to get attention was to blank your teacher.
Well, punch, I wouldn't pinch him and I wouldn't slug him, but I'd sure slap him.
Slap. Slap is not a slug.
It's not?
No. Well, I'll show you the difference.
No.
Can I hold her?
Yes. Right, you grab
now, that
her.
Was an off-the-shoulder
no,
remark.
You grab her. Now, here. Now, this is a slap, you see.
That didn't
and
hurt,
did it? And a slag is like this?
Yes.
Oh, fight him. Fight him.
Go ahead. That's a slug, right.
Okay, there's a difference.
Yes, there is a difference. Bob?
Well, it all depends upon how you want to call attention to oneself. I don't know how to draw a slug. It said kiss.
A kiss. The only way to get attention is to kiss your teacher. Well,
it'll draw a crowd.
Yes, it would. Fanny, what'd you say to this?
I don't know. I was just sitting here thinking, when I was young and pretty, I used to sit in that seat. I used to wear red dresses and get attention now and push down here. Pretty soon I'll be in the audience. And I don't like violence. I said, blow her up.
Blow her up. Now, Charlene, you need two to tie and three to win. Janice said, my car is so old, the wheels are made out of blank. Yes. All right, Charlene. Janice said, my car is so old, the wheels are made out of blank.
Wood.
Wood. They did indeed have wooden wheels on automobiles at one time. But, of course, if you were thinking of an older vehicle, you might have something else.
Yes, I was thinking of a car I used to drive through Calcutta many years ago, and the wheels were made of stone.
Of stone, yes! Of course, yes. Isn't he wonderful?
Fabulous, fabulous, darling.
Show us your stone.
I was thinking about a car I used to drive in Maine.
In Maine?
We're made out of wood.
Wood wheels. All right, Charlene, you got one. It scores 2-1 now. Stone. 2-1 is the score. Car is so old, the wheels are made out of...
Antique wood.
Antique wood.
Now we have a tie score of 2-2. Bob?
I was so happy just a moment ago, I heard from my brother. I said Stone, too.
Your brother is sitting up there and
yes,
he told you Stone.
And I have not seen him in years. We used to make movies together in Calcutta.
Oh, you did?
Yes. I was working on a movie called Double Exposure.
Yes?
It was the story of two holy men who opened a delicatessen in New Delhi.
In New Delhi?
Yes. You get it, folks. In New Delhi, in New Delhi. Well, I'll leave the accents to Fred from here on in. It's going to be a slow week.
Yes. I think you're wonderful. What do you say, Fanny?
Enjoy yourself, honey. It'll pass soon enough. And now you look in the mirror and the little laugh lines you thought were so cute. When you start using a race as your entire makeup base. Oh, I have the correct answer. Even.
All right, Wood wins the game. Come on, guys. Well, Tammy, you didn't win any money, did you?
No.
Well, we're going to send some prizes. What have we got for Tammy? Well, we've got all kinds of good things that will come your way. 7 inches of dental floss.
Thank you.
All that. Here's a little message for you. Darlene's having her second go at the big money here. She's got $500 from her first attempt, and now let's see what happens with her second time. Charlene, we polled this audience, and we said write down your best answer to this. Pomp blank. Remember, it's $500 for matching the most popular. For matching the second most popular, it's $250, and if you match the third, you get $100. Now, which of the dingbats would you like to call on for some assistance?
Fanny. Okay, I think the most popular answer is probably, a friend of mine wrote this book, Pomping Iron. No.
Pomping Iron. Pomp and Circumstance by Sir Edward Elgar.
Oh, how smart. Fred.
You had to call on me second, yes? Thank you so much. Pompadour.
Is that it?
Yes, Pompadour.
Pompadour. All right.
Okay, Bob.
Bob sure. Is looking at you glassy-eyed.
Well, this one came right to me right off the top of my head. I was going to go with pompous ass, but that you can't say that on television. So I'll go for the famous Roman city, Pompeii.
Pompeii. I think that's very good. So you got Pompeii.
You want to bet on it?
Pomp and Circumstance. And Pompadour.
Right.
You want one of those?
Yes.
Which one?
Pomp and Circumstance.
Yay!
Pomp and Circumstance. All right, let's find out if it's up there. Do we have Pomp and Circumstance anywhere on that board, beginning down at the bottom of the $100 response? Pompadour is there.
Yeah.
Very good.
Sure.
All right. Let's take a look at the next one, please. Pomp and Ceremony.
Whoa.
Well, it looks good for Pomp and Circumstance. Let's see if you win another $500 right now. Yes, you do. Very good. Now you've got $1,000, and that amount is yours. However, the additional $500 you've won means that you're going to play for $5,000 minimum. However, a lucky spin of the wheel again will make it $10,000.
Uh-oh.
Good luck to you. Let's all root for a double and see what happens.
It's no me.
Watch out. Watch out, man.
Annie, darling. Go.
$10,000. Bob Donner. No help from the audience, please, because it might be a rotten answer, and that would be unfair. Here it is. Message blank. Take a look at it. Bob's come up with his answer. Now, you want to try to match his. And these have to be exact matches when we get to the big money here. So what do you say to that for $10,000?
Message boy.
Message boy. Message boy. I always think of it as messenger boy.
Yeah.
Bob, maybe Bob has thought of it as message boy. I don't know. We'll find out now. Bob, may we see it, please?
I said message service.
Message service.
That's twice, you goof, Bob. I don't want to make you feel bad or anything,
no, message
but that's
service
twice.
Was not a bad answer.
Thank you, Brett, for holding me up to ridicule in front of the entire audience. And everyone, my mother watches this show.
I will punish her.
If you stick stuff on you at the end. I'm right underneath her.
That's why I share responsibility. I did write boy, but he didn't pay for it.
You did?
Was that boy? He doesn't even know how to steal an answer, does he? Well, Charlene, you got a total of $1,000 and our best wishes. Thank you for being here on Match Game. Now let's welcome Cindy Stockwell and John Murphy.
Yay!
Hey!
That's what I
welcome. Cindy and John. Nice to have
Gene,
both of
how
you
are
here.
You?
I'm very
pleasure.
Well. Thank you for asking.
I brought you some kiwis from Northern California.
Some kiwis from Northern
California? Some kiwi fruit.
Are they ripe?
Yeah, ripe.
Yes.
Yeah.
How do you eat them?
Oh, you just cut them in half. You can scoop them out or peel them, put them around a salad. They're great.
They are?
Oh, they're beautiful.
Did you grow them?
Well, actually, I do have 2.5 acres up there, but I didn't grow these. I got these at the
farmer's market.
No plugs. She said it. Where
she
do you live,
it,
John?
Biggs, California.
Biggs?
Biggs.
Where's that?
That's a little town next to Lake Oroville. 60 miles north of Sacramento.
Oh, that's very pretty up there.
Very pretty.
What do you do for a living, John?
Nothing.
Nothing. Attaboy, John. You got the idea. He's got the idea, hasn't he?
That's a smart man.
My wife works.
Your wife works.
Yeah.
Oh, listen, ERA is going to welcome you with open arms.
Open arms.
Yes, sir. Anything else you want to add about your personal life?
No, if I can't plug nothing, there's...
No.
No,
no, you can't plug anything here because that's illegal. They don't allow you to do it.
Well,
no. If you were going to plug something, what would you plug?
I'm almost afraid to say, you know, them people backstage got me, so I don't want to say nothing. I wouldn't even say Ma Don Kiwi Company, you know. I wouldn't do that.
No, you can't do that.
You can't do that, no.
That's his own private Kiwi Company. All right, John, we've heard enough about you here now. Cindy, tell us about you, please.
Well, I'm Cindy Stockwell. I'm from Oceanside, California. I'm married. I have
two children?
Two children, not a few, two.
Two. How old are they?
My daughter Katie is 4 and my son Robin is 2.
Gosh, you only look 12 yourself.
Thank you. I'm also a full-time college student with a pre-med major, and I work part-time in a grocery store.
You'll be a doctor?
Yep.
Good luck to you. That's marvelous.
What do you do with your spare time?
Excuse me.
I go on game shows.
Your spare time, you go on game shows?
Right.
I'm glad to hear that, Cindy. Well, listen, we'll start this game in a little while. Right now, we have to do this for America. Did you see what Fred did with his eyes?
Yes, I did.
Did you see it, Cindy?
Yes.
I just saw a glimpse of it. Would you get a shot of Fred so he can do that goofy thing with his eyes again?
I used to do that in the Army to drive the doctors crazy.
Really?
You know, they'd go in and say, young man, you're in here sick call. What's the matter with you? And I'd say, I don't know. I woke up this morning and...
They took you anyway?
They took me anyway.
They drafted you anyway, huh? I'd like to see you aim a rifle sometime. Now, Cindy, you have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B it is for Cindy. Now, here it is, friend. Some things just don't make sense. Such a, well, like a book called The Wit and Wisdom of Blank.
Oh, I love the cruel
ones. You love the cruel ones?
Yes.
Now, Cindy, some things just don't make sense. Such as a book called The Wit and Wisdom of...
Jimmy Carter.
Jimmy Carter. She said Jimmy Carter.
I certainly appreciate your reply, young lady. I said Billy Carter.
All right.
You know, it's hard because you really do hate to hurt people's feelings. I'm with Fanny.
Yes.
And so that you try and choose somebody. Well, oh, shucks. Fanny.
Fanny! Now, I happen to think, Fanny...
With no editorial comments are needed, mister.
Wise young lady and full of wit, yes?
One of those questions, I said the wit and wisdom of Frankie Valli. Dear friend of mine.
Betty, some things don't make sense. There's a book called The Wit and Wisdom of...
Richard Nixon.
Richard Nixon.
Hey, you didn't make sense to me, man, you know?
I gotcha. All right, Bob.
Well, you know my brother. I said Billy Carter.
You guys are in tune with one another.
Yes, and right? I don't turn around either.
Yes. Are you sharing a dressing room?
We talk. We're friendly. Friendly. We're not great friends. I wouldn't. I thought it was cruel what Brett did, though.
Thought it was cruel what Brett did?
Yes, personally, I did. And I'd like to apologize for the other members of the panel.
All right. Benny?
Hi, and hello to you, America. I just want to say that Linda and I always hated a person who was cruel and would turn on their best friend. However, my answer was Brett.
Brava, brava!
I do the setup and she gets the laugh.
Well... All right. Cindy didn't pick up any in her first round question. And John, we don't expect you to pick up any either.
But
at least you brought some kiwi fruit there. All right, here we go. Ralph said, my wife is the world's worst cook. How worst is she? Is it? All flunked English grammar, didn't you, there? My wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, she served me charcoal broiled blank.
When Madame Pompadour danced on the floor.
Now we're ready for you, John. Ralph said, my wife is the world's worst cook. Last night, she served me charcoal broiled blank.
Charcoal broiled water.
Water?
Water.
Yeah.
Yeah, water.
I confidently predict the scoreless tie will continue. Because I don't think, weird as we are over here, we're not going to say charcoal broiled water, are we, Fred?
You see, when I was doing Saturday Night Fever, I knew that you could. See, I knew that you could. So, I think... I said spaghetti.
Charcoal broiled spaghetti, right, yes. Right. It's a rotten dish. All right?
Well, they were an older couple, and he'd been a little cranky lately, and she thought he needed something to loosen him up, so she served him some charcoal boiled prunes.
All right. Charcoal boiled prunes.
Jell-O.
Jell-O. Another revolting thing.
Another dumb answer.
May I ask the significance of your wearing a windbreaker with the insignia Los Angeles Police Athletic League? I mean, I admire it. You support the PAL?
No, you can't ask that.
I can't ask that.
No, yeah, no, yes.
No, yes, no, yes.
Yes.
He's sitting on a fence. You support the PAL.
Of course.
They do wonderful things for young people, not only in this city, but
why
in
many. Why is that producer hushing me up and running me off further on? It's because I don't do 200 trick voices? Well, I want it.
Last night she served me charcoal broiled...
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Spaghetti and meatballs.
Right on.
What'd she serve, Bob? Tell us the truth.
Well, John, I tried to think of the dumbest answer I could think of. You whip me, boy. Cereal.
Cereal.
You're a tough act, John.
Yeah. All right, Fanny. Let's have a go at it, Fanny.
I'm just fascinated. You know, they say people have dogs begin to look like their dogs.
Yep.
Look at that kiwi fruit. Whatever. Look at his head. No offense, hon. I must say, the first thing I thought of was water, but I wrote lettuce.
Lettuce it is.
Oh,
yeah.
So there we are. No score at the end of round one. Round two coming up in some future date. Now this. Rayburn, join us next time for the match game. Goodbye.
Some contestants will receive cooking and cleanup are quick and easy with West Bend's cookware, bakeware, and electric skillet. All service is Silverstone. Silverstone spells durability. A calculator and Raid indoor fogger. Its room-filling fog kills roaches, fleas, and other bugs dead by the thousands. A pair of beautiful digital watches for a man and woman. Timex, where making time look good. An ice bucket and relaxing at home. Drink sparkling pink champagne any day when you feel special. Tastes like bubbly wine. Pink champagne malt liquor from Iroquois brand. From Hart's Mountain, gifts for your dog or cat, including the Hart's 2-in-1 Plus collar that kills ticks and fleas for up to 5 months. A tray and Torex, the breath deodorant. Helps your mouth's own freshening power eliminate bad breath. Costs a little more, but it's worth it. Clorox, the breath deodorant. And a calculator and off. And off. Powerless mosquito repellent. Off really works with the most effective mosquito repellent ingredient that money can buy.
Right now, don't miss the show that gives you money for a song. The all-new $100,000 Name That Tune, followed by Wheel of Fortune at 5:30, right here on Channel 7.
Guy Olson speaking for Match Game, a Mark Cripps and Bill Kotman production. Program is edited for broadcast.